Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to go over the difference between master pages and parent pages in Adobe InDesign. All right, let's get started. All right, so the short answer is there is no difference between them. Adobe just decided to change the name from master pages to parent pages because I guess it was kind of controversial, which this thought never even crossed my mind as a designer, but master gives connotations of slavery, and Adobe, of course, did not want to be associated with that. So they changed it to parent pages, which is also a good thing because now it kind of follows web design language. So in web design, you have parent pages and child pages, and now it's the same in InDesign. Okay, so what is a parent page, which used to be called a master page? A parent page are these little pages right up here at the top of your pages panel. And if you're not seeing your pages here, you can come up here to Window, Pages, and it's right here. The cool thing about parent pages is that you can put something on one of these and then apply it to a few different pages or all of the pages in your document. So maybe this would be like a little logo that you wanted on every single page in your document. I'm going to double click on the A parent. You can see I've added a little logo here on the A parent page. And then if I want to apply this parent page to the first five pages, I can click the first one, hold shift to select all of them, and then right click or hold control and choose apply parent to pages. And then the parent I want is A parent. So we'll say okay. And now you can see a little A on each page that has A parent. And there's no little A on five on. So if I double click on page one, you can see we have that logo here. And actually we can't select it anymore. If we want to select it, we have to come up here to the A parent. We can move it over or whatever we want to do with it. And then double click on the page again and you can see it's updated. And if we click on any of these other pages, it's updated on all of them. So it's a really handy thing if you need repetitive objects across multiple pages. Another thing that parent pages are really good for are page numbers. So if we double click on B parent, you can see I've added a little page number right down here. And by the way, if you don't know how to add page numbers, it's not very intuitive, but I do have another video, and that should be right in the upper right corner of your screen right now, that shows how to add page numbers in InDesign. So if we apply this to all the pages in our document, I'm going to select all the pages. I have 25 of them. And then I'll right click or hold control and choose apply parent to pages. We'll just put B on all of these and say okay. On those first five pages, we don't have A on those anymore. We only have B. If you want both a page number and a logo, you would want to either set up a C parent with both of those things on there, or you can also just click and drag the A parent on top of the B, and that kind of makes a child-child page. So everything that's on A is now also on B. I'm going to undo that. But anyway, it doesn't matter which page you click on now, and it'll have the right page number on it. So we're on page 7. You can see the page 7 page number. And if we move this one and drag it over here, it will update with the correct page number. So those are the main two ways that parent pages or master pages are used in Adobe InDesign. They're really handy, and I do use them all the time. All right, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.